And we're going to get underway here. I'm Matt Skinner. I am Public Information Manager for the Oklahoma Corporation Commission. We want to thank the Oklahoma Municipal League for helping us put this together. And we are recording this. It will be available. We will be emailing out a link where you can watch this video at any time. A couple of ground rules. We have everybody who's joining us right now muted. You will be able to ask questions after the presentation. There's a section for questions, so please prepare them beforehand. Then we will unmute and go from there. If there are any issues with feedback or something like that, we're going to have to mute you. So please make sure that you don't have two speakers going at once, that you only have one thing on at a time, that type of thing. So again, welcome, and I'm going to turn it over to Jenny and let her do her own introduction. One moment.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the 405 Area Code Exhaust Relief Virtual Town Hall Meeting. I'm Jenny Dillon, a regulatory analyst for the Public Utility Division of the Oklahoma Corporation Commission. Joining me today from the Public Utility Division is Mark Argenbright, Telecom Manager, and Tina May, Regulatory Analyst. Copies of the meeting materials, including today's presentation, are available on the Public Utility Division's website. Also included on the Public Utilities Division website is a copy of the application and important upcoming dates in this proceeding. After the presentation, we will walk through some frequently asked questions that address some of the major concerns related to area code exhaust relief, and then we will open the floor to any additional questions that we receive. All right, let's go ahead and get started. The FCC holds full jurisdiction over all numbering issues. However, pursuant to 47 CFR section 52.19, a state commission may resolve matters involving the introduction of new area codes within their state. Accordingly, in Oklahoma, the Oklahoma Corporation Commission, or OCC, is responsible for proactively monitoring area code relief planning, for overseeing the integrity and competitive neutrality of the industry relief planning process, and ultimately approving the area code relief plan. Area codes are administered by the North American Numbering Plan Administrator, also known as NAMPA, in accordance with FCC policy and industry guidelines. As you're aware, we have an open cause to address the projected exhaust of the 405 area code, also known as a numbering plan area, or NPA. The cause number is PUD 2018-00086. Today's virtual town hall is an integral part of the Public Utility Division's effort to review the area code exhaust relief process and to hear from the public. Now, I would like to give you a brief history of the area codes in Oklahoma and what the OCC has done to extend the life of the numbers within it. The 405 area code was the original area code for the state and was created in 1947. Today, this area code serves all or portions of 19 counties in the central part of the state, which range from Stillwater in the north, Pauls Valley in the south, Hydro in the west, and Waletka in the east. This 405 area code has a mix of residential, industrial, urban, and rural areas. There are approximately 190 cities and towns within the area code. Tinker Air Force Base, one of the largest military installations in the United States, is located within the 405 area code. Additionally, the main campuses of the University of Oklahoma and Oklahoma State University are located within the area code. The area that now comprises the 918 area code was split from the 405 area code in 1953. In 1997, the area that now comprises the 580 area code was split from the 405 area code. Most recently, in 2011, the 539 area code was added as an all services overlay to the 918 area code. Currently, the available prefixes in the 405 NPA are forecasted to exhaust by December 2021. The 405 area code includes all or portions of the following counties: Blaine, Caddo, Canadian, Cleveland, Garfield, Garvin, Grady, Hughes, Kingfisher, Lincoln, Logan, McLean, Noble, Okfuskee, Oklahoma, Payne, Pottawatomie, Seminole, and Ouachita. The OCC reviews the industry's utilization data on telephone number usage semi-annually. Although the implementation of thousands block number pooling in 2002 helped to extend the life of the 405 area code, the 405 prefixes are currently forecasted to exhaust by December of 2021. Therefore, additional prefixes are needed in the 405 geographical area, which will require introduction of a new area code. Generally, a new area code is introduced by one of two methods, a geographic split or an overlay. However, a geographic split has not been implemented in the United States in the last 12 years. Additionally, a geographic split is not a viable relief option in the 405 geographic area. The most common form of area code relief is an all services overlay. With an all services overlay, the existing geographic area served by an area code is kept intact, and a new area code is added to the same geographic area. New customers or customers adding additional lines could be assigned numbers with the new overlay code. When any overlay is implemented, including an all services overlay, the FCC requires that 10 digits, or the area code plus the 7-digit telephone number, are to be used to dial all calls, even local calls. 10 digits are used for calls to the same area code, as well as for calls to the new area code. One type of overlay is the boundary elimination overlay. A boundary elimination overlay is when the boundary between two or more area codes is eliminated, and codes can be assigned from the adjacent area code in the original area code. 10-digit dialing is also required for all calls, even local calls, in a boundary elimination overlay. On January 4, 2010, the Oklahoma Corporation Commission approved an all-services overlay as the relief method for the 918 area code. The new area code introduced was 539, and it was put into service in April 2011. There hasn't been an area code split in the nation in the last 12 years, and the last geographic split in Oklahoma was 22 years ago. The overlay has become the preferred form of area code relief nationwide. Now I will go through the relief methods that were viable options for the 405 area code. Slide 8 shows the map of alternative number 1, an all services distributed overlay. In this method, a new overlay area code would be added to serve the same geographic area as the current 405 area code. All current customers would retain their existing area code and telephone number. After the overlay area code is introduced, new customers or new lines may be assigned from either the 405 or the new overlay area code. The projected life of the all service overlay is 43 years. Slide 9 shows the map of alternative number 2, a boundary elimination overlay. The boundary between the 405 and the 918 and 539 area codes would be eliminated, and codes from 405, 918, and 539 could be assigned in any of the three area codes. The projected life of alternative 2 is 27 years. The Oklahoma 405 NPA has a wide area calling plan that includes 47 rate centers. The Oklahoma City Rate Center has 45% of all of the code assignments in the 405 NPA. Due to these circumstances, it is not recommended to split the 405 NPA. The Oklahoma telecommunications industry proposed an all-services distributed overlay over the 405 area code, also described as alternative number 1. One significant reason this relief method was proposed by industry is due to the greater projected life of the all services distributed overlay as opposed to the boundary elimination overlay alternative. Additionally, industry has voiced concerns about customer confusion and educational difficulties associated with implementing the boundary elimination overlay. If any of the overlay options are approved by the Commission, you, as a customer, will keep your existing area code and telephone number. Additionally, you will use 10 digits, or the area code plus the 7-digit telephone number, to dial next door or to dial from Oklahoma City to El Reno. The number of digits dialed will not affect how calls are billed. What is a local call now will remain a local call after the overlay is implemented and is included in your monthly service charge if you subscribe to a flat rate service. The 10-digit dialing requirement eliminates a dialing disparity between two customers in the two different area codes. The FCC has mandated that the introduction of any type of overlay will require 10-digit dialing throughout the overlay area. Once the mandatory dialing begins, 7-digit dialing within the overlay area will be eliminated. Calls to 911, as well as 211, 311, 411, and other such numbers will not be affected. Those calls will continue to be dialed with 3 digits as they are dialed now. Existing customers in the 405 area code may need to change stationery, advertising, signage on trucks, billboards, etc. to show the correct area code if only the 7-digit number is shown currently. This includes business cards, invoices, letterheads, advertisements, numbers on checks, and pet tags. Businesses with PBXs would need changes made in their systems to reflect the dialing change in the introduction of the new area code. Burglar and fire alarm and security or entry systems might need to be updated for 10-digit dialing. Consumers may need to reprogram their automatic dialing equipment and other types of equipment that are programmed with only a 7-digit number to ensure the use of the 10-digit dialing procedure. Friends, relatives, and business associates would need to be notified of the change. When introducing a new overlay area code, there is an adjustment period, which is called the permissive dialing period. During the permissive dialing period, customers may dial numbers from the 405 area code to other 405 numbers on either a 7-digit or on a 10-digit basis. Customers will be encouraged to make calls using the new dialing procedure during the permissive period. However, if they forget to use the procedure or if their equipment hasn't been changed yet, the call will still be completed. The permissive dialing period usually lasts several months. At the end of the permissive period, all calls must be made using the correct area code. If the customer dials a 7-digit number by mistake, the customer will reach a recorded announcement stating the number must be dialed using the area code plus the 7-digit number, and the customer must hang up and redial the number using the correct area code. This recording will always be available. Now we'll review some of the most frequently asked questions and answers in area code exhaust relief. How many numbers are available for assignment in an area code? The 405 NPA started with approximately 7.8 million numbers available for assignment. As of October 2019, there are only approximately 300,000 numbers in the 405 NPA remaining for assignment. Will I lose or have to change my phone number? No. With an all services overlay, existing phone numbers will not change. The new area code will only apply to new phone numbers. Who will be affected by the all services overlay? Anyone located in the 405 geographic area. Will the overlay apply to my cell phone? Yes. Overlays are applied to both wired and wireless services. Will I have to change how I make phone calls if an overlay is introduced? Yes, When an overlay is put into effect, callers must use 10-digit dialing or the area code plus 7-digit phone number for all calls. Will an overlay make my phone bill more expensive? No. Calling areas and rates will not be impacted by the overlay. In other words, calls that were considered local before the overlay will remain local calls after the overlay goes into effect. Are there any areas in Oklahoma that have an area code overlay? Yes, an all services overlay was adopted for relief in the 918 NPA, and the 539 area code was introduced in 2011. Is there anything I can do now to simplify the transition to 10-digit dialing? Yes, callers should reprogram any contact list or speed dialers to utilize 10-digit dialing for all calls. Additionally, callers should reprogram life safety systems, alarms, PBXs, fax machine calling lists, private entry access systems, auto dialers, and outdialing lists on personal computers to dial 10 digits for all calls. As I stated earlier, the Oklahoma telecommunications industry has proposed an all-services distributed overlay as the preferred form of relief for the 405 area code, which will be considered by the commission. A hearing on the merits before an administrative law judge will be held in Courtroom B of the Jim Thorpe Building on November 20th, 2019 at 1:30 p.m. Public comment may be filed in the cause, which again is cause number PUD 2018-00086. Alternatively, public comment may be provided via email to telecom@occ.ok.gov. In the subject line, please include the words 405 area code relief. If you would like to speak to PUD's attorney in this cause, please contact Lauren Willingham, Assistant General Counsel at the Oklahoma Corporation Commission, 4th floor, Jim Thorpe Office Building, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma 73105, or via phone at 405-522-8954. And now we will open it up for any questions.
If anyone on the phone has questions, now is your chance. I still see people on the phone and they may be watching us on a delay. So go ahead. Someone there?
Matt, this is Mike Fina One. Thank you so much for doing this today. The others, I think maybe if we could talk about what the next steps are.
The next steps in the process?
Yes.
Okay. So, Jenny, what are the next steps in the process when it comes to moving this through our court system? Go ahead. Why don't you go over the procedural schedule? Well, you don't. We don't have to be exact, but go ahead.
Thanks, Matt. The next step in the process is the hearing on the merits, which is November 20th at 1:30 p.m. PUD has filed testimony in this cause, and as far as I know, there are some other parties that have filed statements of position, but I haven't seen any additional testimony filed. So, you know, PUD will present our testimony in front of the administrative law judge. The judge will have an opportunity to decide which form of area code relief he recommends. He will put that in a document for the commissioners to review. And then at a later date, we're not quite sure when, but in the next couple months, the commissioners will have time to look over the proposed final order and make a decision on the relief method that we're going to go forward with.
Do you anticipate a time frame when this could be wrapped up?
So we're hoping to receive a final order from the commission very early in, let's see, 2020. Shortly thereafter, we'll get the announcement of what the new area code will be. And then we kind of, it leaves the commission hands after the final order and goes to NAMPA and the carriers to begin the implementation process. So there's a short time frame for network preparation. Then we begin the permissive dialing period, which I believe is about 6 months. And during that time, carriers conduct their own customer education efforts. After the permissive dialing period ends, the mandatory dialing period begins, and again, that's about another 6 months. And then after that, we put the new area code into service. So I'm guessing it'll be about 18 months, give or take, by the time we see whatever changes the commission has ordered actually become final.
Any other questions? Hearing none, I again want to thank Mike Fina and the Oklahoma Municipal League for helping put this on. We will be doing others, as you heard in the presentation. We've got a ways to go through this, and we have obviously ample opportunity to discuss this more. This has been recorded, and it will be placed up on our website. You can just go to a homepage, and you will see a link to it. If you have any questions, feel free to call the Public Information Office or the numbers that are given by the Public Utility Division in this presentation. Further, if you would like a town hall meeting or some kind of session with your city council or other entity, please contact me. You can go to our website. You'll find my contact information, Matt Skinner, and we'll see what we can do for you. We're more than happy to come out in person and explain where we are in the process and some of the things that we're going to have to prepare for. I would just like, in one addendum, to make it clear in Jenny's remarks, this is not optional. We are on a path where we are going to have to take some kind of action. This is required by federal statute. So that choice is not left up to the commission. We don't have the choice to do nothing. And to recap, right now, the proposal before the commission is calling for an overlay, which is what was done in the 918 area code in 2011, in which no one's existing phone number changes, but the entire area would have to go to 10-digit dialing. And that's where we are. We're going to give one last chance for questions for anyone on the phone. And hearing none, thank you so much for joining us.